Welcome to the refresher training for volunteers who educate about watercraft inspection in order to help prevent the spread of aquatic invasive species.
We would like to thank you on behalf of the Minnesota Department of Natural Resources for volunteering your time to help protect our state's waters. Your work to keep plant and animal species that are not native to our state out of our waters is a gift you are giving to everyone who enjoys and cares about Minnesota's lakes and rivers. Also, you're helping us avoid the health risks and economic damage caused by these invaders. Our state is fortunate to have dedicated volunteers like you helping with this important work.
As an experienced volunteer, you already know a lot about aquatic invasive species, but it's easy to forget some of the details after the break over the winter months. Think of this training as an opportunity to make sure we're all starting with the same accurate and consistent information to share with the boating public. You might also learn some new information or about recent changes in the DNR's program. And we want to make sure everyone is performing their tasks safely to prevent any injuries. Please take time to view the entire training to make sure you'll have a successful season educating the boating public about aquatic invasive species.
To begin, what is an invasive species? Minnesota statutes define it as a species that isn't native and causes harm to commerce, the environment, or human health, or a species that threatens natural resources or the use of natural resources. Let's review the key aquatic invaders we're facing in Minnesota and the trouble they cause. These are prohibited invasive species. They are illegal to possess, import, purchase, sell, raise, transport, or release into state waters. This is information you may want to share with boaters to help impress on them how their actions can spread species that harm Minnesota's residents and natural resources. There are five characteristics that all of these invading species have in common. They have few natural predators in our ecosystem, so most of them multiply rapidly. They can easily outcompete native plants and animals. They can be spread rapidly by people overland from one location to another. On some occasions, flooding also can carry aquatic invasive species to new locations. They are nearly impossible to eradicate once they get established or gain a foothold in a body of water. And they can cause significant changes and problems in the ecosystems of our lakes, rivers, and streams.